Innovation ecosystems are hotspots of highly concentrated innovation activity, which have a significant density of resources, talent, funding, infrastructure, and demand. They have a highly supportive innovation culture, and they have highly engaged stakeholders, entrepreneurs, universities, risk capital providers, large corporations, and governments. An innovation ecosystem approach is about selecting a small number of innovation hotspots around the world and really focusing open innovation on those key places. Because it is a location-based approach, it means being deeply immersed in a few specific places rather than spread thin worldwide. Today's shift to an innovation ecosystem approach actually simplifies and focuses open innovation, and when done effectively, it can also help drive a transformation in internal innovation.
For corporate leaders and executives, it's important first to realize that innovation has evolved, as you say, from closed through open to now the ecosystem approach, to reckon with the way that innovation is working in the world today. In the past, a corporate could just put money into sponsored research or into M&A activity, but now it's a much broader spectrum of innovation activity they need to be engaging with. Leaders have to decide how they change their own internal organization to actually be able to engage with the ecosystem effectively. So there's quite a bit for leaders to do. So the key questions for leaders as they think about an effective innovation ecosystem are, what locations are they going to use as the core of their innovation ecosystem approach? Is it a location you're already in, or one or more new locations? What do you want from the innovation ecosystems for your organization? What do you have to offer these various stakeholders, especially the startup entrepreneurs? What do you have to offer the stakeholders in these specific innovation ecosystems? What are the mechanisms you will use to engage the stakeholders in this ecosystem? How will you redesign the internal system and processes of your organization in order to make the most of your ecosystem interactions?
So Phil, that's a really helpful list. Thank you for sharing that with us.